Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we are going to learn a topic that is trading multiple, something which is really, really significant and important when you are doing valuations of companies or stock and so on and so forth. So let's learn exactly what the concept is all about. Trading multiples. Trading multiple is nothing but identifying comparable companies. Comparable company means all those companies who are in the same industry. Let's say you're working in pharmaceutical industry and you want to value that pharma company, then you need to take the peer pharma company in the industry itself and performing relative valuation like an expert to find a fair value. Fair value means your valuation of the firm. So what exactly is this trading multiple? Okay, let's begin. See, trading multiple valuation is nothing but identifying comp companies. It's comparable companies, but it's also known as comp companies, and performing relative valuations like expert to find the fair value. That is the valuation, the price of the firm. The trading multiple valuation process starts with first, you know, you need to identify the comp companies in the market, and then selecting the right valuation tools. So you can say the valuation tools is the next task, and finally then preparing the table that can provide easy inferences about the fair value of the industry and the company. So before digging into the nitty-gritty of trading multiples, first let's take a very simple trading example or trading multiple example to illustrate how exactly the thing works. Let's say that you are comparing between two companies. Let's say company Y and there's company Z. At this moment, as an investor, you only know that the share price, the number of shares outstanding for each company, and the market capitalization. Because if you have the share price, if you have the number of shares, then it's really easy to find the market cap. So comparing the share price of Y, let's say the share price, I'm indicating it as P, which is 10 per share, and for company Z, it's 25 per share. You don't understand anything out of this. So how would you tell which company is doing great by looking at the share price? Is it possible? See, that's why you would look for relative value by using trading multiples. First and foremost, you will look at the EPS of each company. You found out, let's say that the EPS of company Y is, let's say, 5 per share. And that of EPS of company Z is, let's say, 9 per share. So by looking at EPS, you come to the conclusion that company Z is making more money than company Y. But that doesn't mean that it has benefited to you or it has given some benefit to you. See, to find how much you would get out of the company or how much you will perceive if you would buy them in the first place, you need to look at the most important multiple, that's called PE. That's price to earning ratio. See, by looking at the PE ratio, you can find the value, you can find the multiple as price divided by earning per share. So that is control R. So you can see it's 2. Let's see what is the difference. So that it's 2 and 2.77. And now it becomes clear that which company is more profitable as you as an investor. So you would get a dollar worth of earning by paying 1.5 to company Y. Whereas this is the perfect interpretation of PE ratio. And in case of Z, you would get a dollar worth of earning by paying 2.77 to company Z. Now that means company Y is certainly, you can say, more beneficial for you as an investor. So let's go a step-by-step approach. Let's take a step-by-step approach for trading multiple valuation table. See, in this particular section, we'll go step by step and we'll talk about how each step briefly. After going through the whole section, you would get a very clear idea how to use a trading multiples for valuing a company, a crystal clear idea. The step one that starts as you need to identify, as we had discussed, the comparable companies in the industry itself. As you can see, there are a list of companies and these are the comparables which will be used. We have price, market cap, so by that we can receive number of shares, and there is another valuation metric, that is EV, that has been used. The first question that investor asks is how much we identify the comparable company. How would we identify? The question is quite obvious. Since there are many companies in the industry, how would one know which is the right company? So first, what you need to do is that you need to look for business mix. That's the most important thing in this. Business mix, okay? Under the business mix, you would see the three things. One is called the product, the another is called the service and offered by the company, and the third is the geographical area by which they serve the customer. The second most important thing is that you would see the size of the company. Under the size, you can choose any or all three determinants, like revenue, okay? Then you have the total assets, and or you can say and or EBITDA margin, very important. See, the idea is to find out the right industry, right service products, and right trading multiples. Additionally, you know, we'll be looking in example if possible. Second step, looking at the trading multiple for valuation, for trading multiple. Okay, this is how we are going to value. Now, there are a list of trading multiples that we'll evaluate. See, there are various multiples we can use for valuing a company. And here we are going to talk about the same. The first and the foremost is EV by EBITDA. Now, this is one of the most common trading multiple. The purpose of using EV, that is enterprise value, not only considers the market cap, you can say, but it also takes into account, also takes the debt into account. Even EBITDA also takes debt into account, and not the immediate cash item. And that's why EV by EBITDA is the most reliable multiple investor and analyst use to value the company. The right range of EV by EBITDA is close enough to 6 to 15x usually in that scenario. Then we have next in our list is EV by revenue. Now this is also another common multiple that is used a lot. The multiple is applicable to only those situations where EBITDA of the company is negative. Now, if EBITDA is negative, EV by EBITDA wouldn't be much useful. And for the companies that have just started their journey, a negative EBITDA is way too common. However, EV by revenue isn't a great multiple to be used when two companies have similar revenue, but can be pretty different and how much operate. See, you can say that EV by revenue multiple ranges in close enough to 1 to 3x. The next set that we are going to understand is the PE ratio. Now, the PE ratio, this multiple is specifically useful because EBIT is calculated after adjusting the depreciation amortization, you know, but there is another common multiple that investors use to find out about the price they need to pay for the earning a dollar. It is almost similar to equity value to net income. It usually should range around 12x to 30x. So these are the trading multiple you should use. The next step is going to be comparing. You need to compare the multiples with the comparable company. Compare the multiples with comp companies, right? This is the last step of the whole process. And in this stage, you will look at various trading multiples of the target company and will compare the comparable companies. Now, the general metrics to look at are very simple. Like, you know, you can use mean, median, low or high. If a company's multiple is above the mean and median, you can say that we tend to infer the company and may be overvalued. On the other hand, if the multiple is below the mean and median, we may infer it as undervalued, right? So high and low helps us understanding the outliers and a case to remove those if they are too far away from the mean and the median. Now, there are a couple of things that you need to note while interpreting the trading multiples or while going through the trading multiples. See, first is many trading multiples can mislead you. You know, it's better if you look for the forward, that's very important, forward trading multiples instead of looking at the past data. Second, EV by EBITDA multiple, we just discussed over here. EV by EBITDA multiple is one of the best use if you're comparing the target company with big companies. Okay. And for startup, one of the best multiple is EV by revenue, which we just learned. Now, PE ratio, that is the third, should be used at all, it shouldn't be used at all. Now there are two reasons behind it. First, PE ratio are mostly affected by the cap sources, that capital sources, and secondly, PE ratio is calculated by taking the overall earnings into account, and overall earnings include the non-ops, that is the non-operating charges like write-offs and restructuring charges and some amortization expenses and so on and so forth. If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.